We've all acted out this scenario in our head where we jack in our office job to pursue the dream of becoming a forensic psychologist, writing a thriller, winning Love Island. But, for most of us, it just isn't happen like that. We're not living in a Sophie Kinsella novel. So, what are the small everyday goals that will get us closer to that dream job? We spoke to a couple of career experts to get their top tips. Advertisement, continue reading below. We also caught up with two of the Cosmopolitan homemade housemates, Nicola Bushnell and Emily Purser, who moved into the Cosmo House last year to take advantage of a reduced London rent and pursue careers in their chosen creative industries. Here's how they landed those dream roles, along with their work wardrobe essentials from V by Very. 1. Try different things. Nicola Bushnell: it's a running joke with my friends that I've tried every job under the sun, flight attendant for a private jet, PA, beauty therapist, massage therapist, assistant chalet manager, face painter, Uber driver, personal trainer, TV runner. I learned a lot about myself and what my ideal job would offer me, says Nicola, 33, who's now found her niche as a freelance event photographer. If you're not sure what you want to do, Kate Bosomworth, CMO at M. If you do an internship, make it a good one. Don't work for free for months on end. You don't, and shouldn't, have to. Check company websites and social media. Make sure you're sending your CV to the right person. Use your contacts to the full and get on LinkedIn, too. Stick to your style. Emily Purser: my general look is an eclectic mix of styles with vintage pieces thrown in with high street buys, lots of color and patterns, says Emily, 29, who has just moved into a new role at University of the Arts London, where she'll spearhead projects that support the university's equality and diversity agenda. She adds, the fashion in my office is quite varied, so there's a lot of scope for keeping your own style. To make my wardrobe work appropriate, I mix smart and casual. One day, it'll be a tailored look with trainers, or a slouchy jumper with a pencil skirt. My signature look is big earrings and bold lipstick. It's about dressing for the situation, but still looking like you. V by Very Image, blazer, 55 pounds, Michelle Keegan for Very, trainers, 65 pounds, Converse for Very, earrings, 10 pounds, t-shirt, 18 pounds, trousers, 28 pounds, all V by Very 3. Make connections. I've never had a 5-year plan but have taken opportunities as they've arisen. It can be difficult leaving university to even know what the options are, and jobs in competitive industries are not easy to come by, particularly at entry level. Emily says, I did an MA in curating, which gave me a better understanding of what kind of career I'd like to have. I took a job working front of house at a gallery. At the time, it didn't feel like it was in the right direction, but it was a stepping stone that led to my next role as assistant to the artistic director. It can be hard to see the importance of experience you're gaining until afterwards, but each job or project is a chance to learn and develop, even if just realize what you don't want to do. If you're trying to find your in, Kedge Martin, founder of mentor program Youngbo, advises, so many roles eventually go to someone who has a link to the company. It's surprising when you sit down and think, who do I know, in a certain field, you can usually find contacts to have coffee with and always ask them for 2 more people you can meet. V by Very Advertisement, continue reading below. Image, shirt, 30 pounds, sandals, 32 pounds, midi skirt, 30 pounds, crossbody bag, 25 pounds, all V by Very 4. Perfect your CV. Kedge explains, people often try to cram too much onto their CV. The best examples are clear and easy to read, 1 page of A4 is enough, or max 2 pages if there's enough content, and not any fluff. Kate adds, kick off with a very carefully written personal statement, no more than 1 paragraph, but be careful, as they can be very vanilla. state the obvious or sound like everyone else, hardworking, enthusiastic, team player, aren't we all? 5. Do your interview prep on the day, arrive at least half an hour before and sit in the cafe for 30 minutes, relax your breathing, run through your strengths and examples you can draw upon in your head, says Kedge. 6. Focus on first impressions. Kedge explains, first impressions are key, and that means every day, you never know who you might bump into. Make sure your social media is appropriate, as most employers search it to find out more on candidates. Hopefully, you're aiming to work in the right environment and with a team that suits your personality, so you'll naturally present yourself in your best light. Be relaxed, but err on the side of formality, as you can always dress down or take the jacket off. Advertisement, continue reading below. Advertisement, continue reading below. V by Very Image, shirt, 28 pounds, sandals, 35 pounds, trousers, 28 pounds, crossbody bag, 18 pounds, all V by Very 7. Take the right opportunity. Skate advises, grasp the right opportunities, rather than every single one. If you know what you're looking to do, where you want to be in the next few years, these opportunities will be easier to identify. If they don't appear, create them. Ask to be considered for things, to start something, to be involved in a project you've seen. I doubt the response will be a no. 8. Ask for feedback. What are you working to achieve in your role? You should ask for broader feedback more regularly. Always be open and explain why you're looking for feedback. Consider 2 to 3 areas you want to be more aware of or need help with, says Kate. Advertisement, continue reading below. 9. Follow your intuition. For anyone who isn't happy in their career, I'd say don't be afraid to try things and take risks. No guts, no glory, says Nicola. I think people can also be scared of other people's judgment and worry people will think they're flaky and a failure if they try something and don't like it. There's no such thing as failure, as you learn from each new experience, especially if it eventually leads you to your dream role. 10. Be nice. Being friendly and approachable makes a huge difference to the office vibe and makes it much easier to work together as a team. People respect the effort you put in, so offering to help out with extra projects and voicing your opinions is a good way to make an impression and stand out, says Emily. Kate adds, you might be nailing your sales targets, but if everyone thinks you're an asshole, you won't last long. 11. Don't undervalue yourself. In my view, everyone, men and women, experiences imposter syndrome at some stage in their careers, says Kate. You just have to believe that if you're in the room, or at the table, on the platform, whatever the situation, you're meant to be there and others will be delighted that you are and not one of them is questioning your presence. Head up, smile and get stuck in. For all your stylish work wardrobe essentials, check out V by Very.